Acts chapter 2, verse 1. I'm reading from the New King James Version, and I want you to follow along. If you have a different version, or if you want to follow me, you can follow along on the screen. When the day of Pentecost had fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled the whole house where they were sitting. Then there appeared to them divided tongues as a fire, one sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. And there were dwelling in Jerusalem Jews, devout men from every nation under heaven. When this sound occurred, the multitude came together and were confused because everyone heard them speak in his own language. Then they were all amazed and marveled, saying one to another, "Look, are not all these who speak Galileans? How is it that we hear each in our own language in which we were born, Parthians and Medes, Elamites, those dwelling in Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia, Pamphylia, Egypt, and parts of Libya adjoining Cyrene, visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs? We hear them speaking in our own tongues the wonderful works of God." So they were all amazed and perplexed, saying one to another, "Whatever could this mean?" Others, mocking, said, "They are full of new wine." But Peter, standing up with the 11, raised his voice and said to them, "Men of Judea and all who dwell in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and heed my words." Amen. You may be seated in the presence of our God. For however long we're in the book of Acts, I'm going to be preaching about this. I'm sick of having church. I'm sick of having church. One of my favorite movies, I must admit, is a movie that stars Cedric the Entertainer, Vanessa Williams, Solange Knowles, and as fresh as I'm is, who I think they like me, Bow Wow, called The Johnson Family Vacation. One of my favorite scenes is when they get almost to where they're going to the reunion and the car breaks down. And they call Uncle Earl. Yeah, some of y'all done seen it. They call Uncle Earl to come fix the car because they think something has broken in the car. Uncle Earl looks at the car, car's all beat up and everything. And Uncle Earl says to Vanessa Williams, because Cedric's not there, he's up a pole using the phone. Uncle Earl says to Vanessa Williams, that the first thing, Dorothy, that's wrong with this car is that y'all ain't got no gas. You're gonna get this in a minute. If you saw the movie, you know that when he got the car, Nate picked up that car, it was tricked out with Burberry interior. Don't act like you don't know what Burberry is. Some of y'all got the fake. Had Burberry interior. Had a major navigational system. Laptop in the back of the seat. TV monitors. Fine as wine. Spinners rolling on 20s. On a wine-colored navigator. Tricked out. Trimmed out, looking good, but couldn't perform. Because it had no gas. Somebody gonna get this in a minute. It looked good, it looked sweet. Everybody was hating on it, everybody wanted it. But it couldn't run. Because it was empty of what it needed to be filled with in order to operate. Somebody go get it. And because it was empty, watch this, it couldn't get to the garage to get fixed, so Uncle Earl had to carry it. Because when you aren't filled with what you need to operate, somebody always has to carry you. I thought about that because as I start this series on the book of Acts, There are two people that are prevalent in the church today, church shoppers and church hoppers. Oh, yeah, we're going to preach. They're prevalent in the body of Christ today. Everybody's shopping for a church. And God knows ain't nobody got loyalty to stop hopping from churches. Y'all got quiet. And everybody's shopping and hopping because they looking for something. They're searching for something. And I've come to the conclusion the reason folk keep shopping and keep hopping is because what they're looking for, they are looking for on the wrong premise. The thing that I hear more often than not is, I didn't like that church because I couldn't feel the Spirit. The last time I checked, the Spirit wasn't about feeling, it was about filling. Come on, I ain't gonna be long today, but I guarantee you we're gonna make a church here. The reason you keep hopping is because you're trying to feel something that is not supposed to be felt. The Holy Spirit is not some it to be felt. It is a personality that fills you. Are you hearing me in here today? You're running around here talking about, I don't feel the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit ain't trying to let you feel him. But the Holy Spirit is trying to fill you. And I've come to discover that if you're going to be a church marching for the master, and if you're going to be a person activated for the kingdom, the one thing you've got to be is filled with the Holy Spirit. Y'all done got quiet on me now. Because if you are not filled, you'll be just like that navigator in Johnson Family Vacation. You'll be tricked out, have all the trimmings, have the big Bible, wearing the big cross, got the position. I wish you'd talk to me in here. Wearing the Kojic hat. I wish you'd talk to me in here today. Got your stockings on and your Sunday go to church clothes on. But if you are not filled, you ain't going nowhere. The reason some folk been in church 50 years and are just as hellish today as they were 50 years ago is because they got trimmings but ain't got filling. Oh, I came to preach it in here today. You can have position, you can have prominence, you can have trimmings, you can have trappings, you can be tricked out, but if you ain't filled. And let me tell you something. When you get filled, you ain't just getting filled on regular stuff. I'm a premium saved Christian. You can't fill me with nothing else, because if I get filled with the wrong stuff. Come on, y'all gonna talk to me in here today? Now let me help you understand, because I ain't gonna be long today. Let me help you understand what filling ain't. I know that ain't the right way to say it, but that's the way I want to say it. Filling with the Spirit ain't got nothing to do with you speaking in tongues. Oh, y'all done got quiet on me now. I believe in the gift of tongues. It is a gift of the Holy Spirit. It is the least of the gifts, according to Paul. But don't get it twisted. A gift of tongues ain't the evidence of filling or salvation. Boy, y'all done got quiet on me here now. The filling of the Holy Spirit is not about tongues. It is about actively engaging you to operate on a level you could not operate on in your own human ability. It ain't about speaking in tongues. It ain't about being slain in the Spirit. It's not about your denomination. Quit running around here talking about, I'm looking for a denomination filled with the Holy Spirit. It ain't got nothing to do with your denomination. Baptist folk are filled. AME folk are filled. Episcopal folk are filled. Presbyterian folk are filled. Y'all ain't talking to me in here now. And the reason y'all ain't talking to me is because we've gotten so much jacked up theology from jacked up preachers about what the filling is all about, who use the filling to prostitute the gospel to fill their churches. That ain't what the filling is about. You can't be saved without the filling of the Holy Spirit, because it is the filling of the Holy Spirit that activates your mind to confess something you would never confess in your own intellect. Somebody tell your neighbor, that man preaching, it's It's the filling of the Holy Spirit. And I thought this would be the place to start, because this is the year of overflow. I believe this is going to be the year of the supernatural outpouring of the Holy Spirit in this church. I believe healing is going to take place. I believe deliverance is going to take place. I believe bondages are going to be broken. I believe in this place the Holy Spirit is going to pour himself out in a way you have never seen before in your life. I believe in Bethel Baptist Institutional Church, folk are going to get the gift of tongues, the gift of prophecy, the gift of healing, the gift of helps. Y'all ain't talking to me in here today. And I'm preaching this because I'm sick of having church. And I'm ready for some Holy Ghost-filled encounters when we get together in the name of the Lord. I'm sick of coming here Sunday after Sunday and don't nothing change for some folk. I'm sick of Sunday after Sunday we preach and some of y'all still full of gossip, still full of lies, still living in hell, still sleeping with everybody, still shacking up, still can't pay your bills, still don't know who you are, still ain't got no economic empowerment. I'm sick of having church. Y'all don't want to talk to me in here now? I'm sick of gathering 3,000 plus on Sundays, but don't nothing change in your life. I'm sick of coming to church where you ain't got to guess about what the Lord's going to do, because everything we do is the same way we've always. I'm sick of having church. I'm sick of opening with a prayer, going to a hymn, choir singing, going to the offering, having the invitation, always remember Jesus and go home. I'm ready for something new to happen where the Holy Ghost outpours in this place. Is there anybody in here who's ready to have it in here? Now, if somebody's sitting next to you with their arms folded, they ain't ready. That's all right. But I'm looking for some folk in here who are ready to say, I'm sick of having church, and I'm ready to have an encounter. So in this text, they come to the day of Pentecost, which is one of the festivals of the Jewish calendar. And as they come to the festival of the Jewish calendar, there is the release of what is called Pentecost. Pentecost, the release of the Holy Spirit in a way they had never seen it. This ain't the first time the Holy Spirit has acted, y'all. The Holy Spirit brooded over the face of the waters in the book of Genesis. Don't get it twisted. This ain't the first outpouring of the Holy Spirit. But in this chapter, the Holy Spirit outpours himself in a way it's never been seen before. And so just for a few minutes, because I ain't got much voice, but I got enough to get this in here. Let me show you three things, and next Sunday we're going to continue. First, there is the formula for the filling. Y'all ain't going to like this. The first thing that happens in the formula for the filling really doesn't happen in chapter 2, Bob. It happens at the end of chapter 1. The first thing that needs to happen before you get the filling is that there's going to be a replacement of some relationships. When you get ready to be filled with the Spirit in a supernatural way, and when God is ready to take you to the next level, there are some people who've been in your life that can't go. I wish y'all would talk to me. There are some people who have been in your life that God says you can't go to the next level until you release them from your life. Because there's some folk in your life that will mess up your new season if you carry them with you. Watch this. And I'm not talking about just bad folk. There are some people who have been good to you, but were only meant to be good for a season. Your problem is you trying to hold on to them for eternity. Watch text. Text says at the end of chapter 1, something happens. They have to replace somebody. Because people are replaceable. Touch your neighbor and tell him, I think he just said something. Don't ever make the mistake of thinking that you are all that to the extent that God can't replace you. And you better hear me in here today. Don't ever think you're the cat's meow or the dog's bow wow to think that you can't be replaced. I'm replaceable. So if I'm replaceable, what makes anybody else think that they are not replaceable in the kingdom of God? Touch your name and tell them you can be replaced. Yeah, they didn't like that. People are replaceable. And I don't know about you, but I'm thankful for the replacement plan of God. Because, baby, when some folk walked away, I thought life was over. But how many of y'all can testify when they walked away, God was only making room for the real person? Y'all ain't ready for this. Y'all ain't. How many of y'all can shout today? Because you cried when they left, but you shouted when God replaced them. And y'all ain't ready for me. How many of y'all can say, I know God's replacement plan? Because he took one person but brought the right one. He took one job but brought the right one. I didn't get that house, but I found the right one. Now watch what happens. Here's Judas. Judas is dead. Now understand who Judas is. Judas is the treasurer. He got position. Oh, Jesus. He got position. It's interesting that he is replaced by a man named Matthias that we ain't never heard of. Because in the new season, folk that have been unheard of are going to be elevated. Y'all ain't helping me. See, one of the problems in the church is we always want to replace people with folk who always been there. Y'all ain't going to like this series. I see that now. You want to use the same old kind of folk doing the same old kind of thing because they've been here and know the way we do. Hush your mouth. Because the text says that there are some Matthiases in the group who ain't been with you always but got the gift you need to go to the next level. Do I have any folk in here who know you ain't been in Bethel all your life, but God has given you a gift to be used in this place, and you don't care who tries to shut you up or sit you down because you ain't been here? Tell them, my name is Matthias. Oh, some of y'all ain't liking this word. God says, I ain't gonna feel it like I can until you replace Judas with Matthias. Now watch what happens. Watch what happens. When they replace Judas, the word of the Lord says, I better not do this in chapter 2, it says, and suddenly. I better not do this. I better not do this. Will you just throw your head back and say, suddenly? No, y'all didn't say it like you. Say it, suddenly. Uh-huh. Because when the Spirit really falls, it falls suddenly. In other words, it can't be timed. So if it can't be timed, it can't be manipulated. You can't make the Spirit come. Oh, y'all done got quiet on me now. You can pray your language. You can hit a drum, hit a hammer, run a dance and everything else. But you can't make the Spirit fall sudden. There is the blessing of sudden. Some blessings happen in the future. There's the blessing of what's coming for me. How many of y'all get excited about what you know the Lord has coming for you? I came to make an announcement. God told me to tell somebody that what's coming for you ain't coming in the future. It's coming suddenly. This is a season of suddenly. I don't know who this is for. Suddenly means without warning. It means unexpected, unanticipated. And God told me to tell somebody in here, you've been waiting on a blessing later on this year, but it's going to come ahead of schedule. Y'all ain't helping me. Is there anybody in here who needs the Lord to come ahead of schedule? Is there anybody in here who can say, God, I need you to come suddenly. I don't need the money next month. I need it. I don't need the healing in June. I need it. High five your neighbor. Tell him, get a good look at me right now because I'm about to walk into a season of Saturday. I ain't got nobody who believes it. God told me to tell somebody that the blessing you're going to get is out of human control. Can't nobody block it. Can't nobody stop it. Can't nobody oppose it. It's coming suddenly. High five your neighbor and tell them suddenly. You're going to get a call for a job you weren't looking for suddenly. You're going to get an approval for a loan you thought you weren't going to get suddenly. You're going to go back to the doctor. They're going to tell you you don't need to take the medicine no more suddenly. I wish I had somebody in here who believes that the Holy Spirit can show up suddenly without warning, without anticipation, not on your timetable, but suddenly. See, the thing I like about the Holy Spirit is if it's suddenly, that means you can't stop it, you can't arrange it, you can't orchestrate it. I wish I had somebody in here. And God told me to tell somebody that you might as well get ready for some Sundays in Bethel, because we're walking into a season of suddenly. Out of nowhere, folk are going to start running. Out of nowhere, folk are going to get slain. Out of nowhere, folk are going to start praying in their heavenly language. Out of nowhere, folk are going to get healed of cancer without chemotherapy. It's going to happen. That's the formula. You got to replace some folk, and then you got to be ready for what you can manipulate. There's the fallout. There's the formula, rather, but then there's the fallout of the filling. There's the formula for the filling. There's the fallout from the filling. Watch this. Oh, God. Verse 2 says, and the Spirit fell on the whole house. I never noticed it before. It didn't fall on certain people. It fell in the whole house. Y'all ain't catching that. It didn't just pick out folk. It fell, which means if you don't experience something, it's not because the Spirit wasn't available. Because it fell on the y'all ain't caught it yet. When the Spirit pours, it doesn't pour on certain folk. It permeates the whole room. And who's ever in submitted position to inhale the cloud of the glory will pick up what falls. It ain't gonna fall on one pew. It's falling on the whole house. Folk on the back of the balcony. Folk in the front of the church. Folk on the side in the choir. Everybody has the accessibility and the availability to the Spirit that falls. It fell on the whole house. Watch this. When it fell on the whole house, they started speaking in languages, not tongues. Let me straighten it out. This ain't speaking in tongues. This is languages, foreign languages. See, we missed the whole point. Folk misuse this scripture saying, see, that's the evidence that the baptism of the Holy Spirit makes you speak in tongues. No, that's languages. The principle of it is that when the Spirit falls upon you, stuff that you don't have the ability to do, you start doing and don't even know how you're doing it. Y'all ain't ready. How many of y'all, okay, let me make it practical. Some of y'all looking at me. How many of y'all know that you loving some folk you can't stand and still ain't figured out how you able to not be nasty to them? That ain't nothing but the feeling. Y'all ain't trying to help me. How many of y'all know there's some folk you intended to cuss out? But when you got in front of them, a spirit of niceness came over you. Y'all ain't trying to talk to me. That ain't nothing but the filling of the whole. You had every intention of telling that boss off, but when you got there, when the Spirit falls,
you get the ability to do things you could not do in your own ability and don't even know how it's happening. You start doing stuff you swore you never would do. You start acting ways you thought you never could act. I wish I could talk to some of y'all in here today. That's what the filling of the Holy Spirit is all about. Now watch this. They are speaking languages that are not their own. They're all speaking different languages. Because when the Spirit shows up, there is the manifestation of diversity. Everybody ain't doing everything the same way. But we all doing it toward the same goal. Y'all ain't helping me. Everybody wasn't speaking the same language, but they were talking about the same stuff. See, that's why you don't mess with me if I don't do like you do in church. If I dance, leave me alone. If all I do is fold my arms, leave me alone. If I cry, leave me alone. If I run, leave me alone. If I fall out, leave me alone. Because we all don't do it the same way, but it's towards the same goal. And is there anybody in here who can say, I don't act like the person next to me acts, but when the Spirit gets in me, I got to do something. There is a response that I have. And if you don't like the way I do it, we just ain't speaking the same language. But we all talking about the same thing. Will you look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, neighbor, we don't speak the same language, but we talking about the same thing. My language is shouting. My language is dancing. My language is running. My language is crying. My language is jumping. My language is rocking side to side. But we all talking about the same thing. We're talking about how we love Jesus. We're talking about how he is our Savior. We're talking about how he healed us. We're talking about how he delivered us. Now, can I ask y'all a question? Are y'all just dumb or y'all don't know your language? Because some of y'all sitting looking at me like you don't know how to speak your language. I need you to speak your language real quick. When I think of the goodness of Jesus. I don't know what your language is, but do you have a language in here? When I think of how he saved me, how he healed me, how he picked me up, how he dried my tears. Tell your neighbor, scoot over some. I got something to say. I might not say it like you say it, but I got something. Do you know your language? Will you push your neighbor and ask your neighbor, do you know your language? Tell them then why you ain't saying nothing. Turn behind you, ask your neighbor, do you know your language? Then why you ain't saying nothing? If your language is crying, cry all you want. If your language is sitting contemplatively, contemplate all you want. If your language is running, take your shoes off and take off. If your language is jumping, get to jumping. If your language is screaming, open up your black mouth. If your language is... Now, if your language is deaf and dumb, just lift your hand. If you can't say nothing, just lift your hand. If you ain't got no language, you in the wrong church. Because I'm sick of having church. How can you come to church and not have a language? How can God be good to you and you not have a language? How can God heal your body and you ain't got no language? How can God take you off drugs and you ain't got no language? How can God deliver you from homosexuality and you ain't got no language? How can God pay your bills and you ain't got no language? How can you be black in America and you ain't got no... From Jim Crow to freedom, you better open up your mouth. From slavery to liberty, you better open up. And if you're one of my white brothers and sisters in here, how can you be white comfortable in a black church and ain't got no language? It's a new day, baby. If you're comfortable enough to be who you are and be with folk that don't look like you, it ought to give you a language to say, God, I thank you. I ain't living in segregation. I'm living in liberation. Sick of having church. Sick of a black church and a white church and I'm sick of having church. Y'all sit down. Cause watch what happens. I'm almost through. I promise you, Mom, I'm almost through. Watch what happens. There's a group of folk who come because they hear what's going on. And they say, hey. Okay, aren't these Galileans? Go back to the book of John. Don't go back there, but, you know, in your mind. The Gospel of John, where they say, hey, we found the Messiah. And they say, no, y'all couldn't have found him. Can any good thing come out of Nazareth? Nazareth, Galilee, all associated together. Do you know the man from Galilee? Nazareth and Galilee was the ghetto. So the reason these devout Jews, that's what it says in the text. In other words, the educated folk heard what was going on, but saw who was doing it and said, nah, ain't no way in the world this can be happening through ignorant folk, because they don't have the intellectual and educational capability to be linguistically profound enough to speak in languages they ain't never studied. But they don't understand what happens when the Spirit pours itself out. When the Spirit pours itself out, it ain't got nothing to do with your education. It had nothing to do with your intellect. It has nothing to do with where you were born. And there will always be people who can't believe what's happening in your life because they know where you came from. Y'all missed the shout right there. How many of y'all know you got some folk who know what you used to be, know what you used to do, know how you used to do it, and they always looking at you, telling, I can't believe you. Tell them, yeah, it's me. Because when the Spirit, I dare you to look at somebody in here that used to go to the club with you and tell them, yeah, it's me. I dare you to find somebody you know you used to drink Cutty Saw with. Tell them, yeah, it's me. Don't y'all get holy on me in here. I dare you look at somebody you used to say, I better not say it, but look at them and tell them, it's me. Don't think it can't be me. I may not have education. I may not have a PhD. I may not live behind a gated community. I may not have thousands of dollars in my bank account. But when the Lord drops on me, ain't no telling what I'll get the power. I'm almost through, so watch what happened. So text says, we hear him speaking our own language. Then it says, but others, yeah, verse 11, but others said they're drunk. Now, I had a little confusion, because it said all of them were amazed, but then others mocked. All were amazed, but others mocked. I was a little confused, because I thought all meant everybody. So if everybody is amazed, who are these others? If all were amazed, ain't no room for nobody else. And the Spirit said, no, because others here is not a description of a new numerical group. Others is a description of a consciousness within the numerical group. Others were is a description of a group in the all that don't think like the all. Because when the Spirit pours out, there will always be in the crowd some others. Yeah. Others who don't get it. Others who don't want it. Others who try to negate it. I don't know why they're doing all that over there. Others. That boy just done gone crazy and he done turned his daddy out too. Others. Well, I heard they were going to change the name of the church. Others. Well, you know, they done got so Pentecostal and full gospel over there. I just can't go over there no more because it's too loud. Others. I used to like it, you know, when they used to sing all them high anthems, but now they done just got so ghetto. I don't have to. Others. Well, I switched and started coming to the 745 because it's a little more contemplative and serene. Others. Y'all done brought that boy back to Jacksonville and he just done turned, got women up there preaching. Y'all know we don't do that in the Baptist church. Others. You know, we used to just have a little prelude before church. Now they got this praise team up there singing and jumping. Others. Got folk dancing in front of the church like they in jazz co. Others. I don't understand what he done to that church. He got folk coming to that church looking any kind of way. And I even heard all the drug dealers go there. Others. Matter of fact, I even heard he was selling drugs. I ain't got to sell a drug, baby. I got money. Others. Always others in the crowd that seek to negate the move of the Spirit. But there have to be others in the crowd because your faith in the move can't be tested until you go through antagonistic spirits trying to counter it. You got to know how to deal with the others. All right, let me close. There's the formula for the filling. There's the fallout from the filling, but then there's the freedom in the filling. Watch this verse. It's gonna mesh up. It says after them others talked, it says, watch this. But Peter, standing. Church folk don't know when to shout. But Peter, verse 14. Standing. The others said they drunk with wine. The others said everybody in the club getting tipsy. But Peter, standing. That's all I'm going to deal with. I'm going to deal with the rest of what he said next week. But Peter, standing. Y'all ain't got the shout yet. The last time we saw Peter, he was high. But Peter, standing. Y'all ain't got. The last time we saw Peter, he was crying. But Peter, y'all ain't got a check. The last time we saw Peter, he was doubting. But Peter, y'all ain't got this thing yet. The last time we saw Peter, he was running. But Peter, standing. The last time we saw Peter, he was questioning. But Peter, y'all ain't got it yet. The last time we saw Peter, he was suicidal. But Peter, standing. Because when the Holy Spirit fills you, the stuff you used to do, you don't do no more. God gives you a new attitude. Is there anybody in here who can say, I know I'm filled because the stuff I used to do, I just don't do no more. And if there's one person the devil is scared of, he's scared of anybody he thought he had down, but has the nerve enough to stand. You know why the devil is running from me today? Because he thought I wouldn't have the nerve to preach after having a bacterial infection all in my throat all week long. But since I'm up here today, the devil don't know what to do, because he doesn't know how to handle people who handle him by getting up when he thought he had him down. Would you tell your neighbor he talking about me? Because the devil thought he had me. The devil thought he had messed me up. The devil thought he had used me up. But I'm standing. Would you high five your neighbor and tell him, I used to be scared, but now I'm standing. I used to be quiet, but now I'm standing. Some of y'all swore you'd never be a shouter, but look at you now. You swore you'd never say amen in church, but look at you now. You swore you'd be shy all your life, look at you now. You swore you'd never open up that business, but look at you now. You swore you'd never get married, look at you now. You swore you'd never make anything of your life, but look at you now. I need somebody to stand up in here and tell the devil what I used to do. I don't do no more. You should have killed me when I was running. You should have killed me when I was hiding. You should have killed me when I was crying. But now I'm I wish I had some standers in here. Are there any standers in here? Are you standing in here? Are you standing in here? Tell the devil you should have got me when you had me. But now I'm But then the Lord said to me, preacher, I'm finna kill it. He said, you messed up. That's not the principle. Things I used to do, I don't do no more. I said, why you say that, Spirit? He said, because don't you remember? Before the enemy sifted Peter, he was impulsive, arrogant, impetuous, loud, and bold. The Spirit, oh Jesus. The Spirit said to me, preacher, what he does there is simply what he used to do before the enemy took it from him. I came to make an announcement. God's about to give somebody back something the devil took from you. I came to make an announcement this morning. Some of y'all lost your joy. Some of y'all lost your smile. Some of you lost your confidence. Some of you lost your security. Some of you lost your economy. But God told me to tell you, this is the season where you gonna get back everything that the devil took from you. Will you look at somebody, tell them, get a good look at me now. Because the next time you see me, I'm going to be different than I am today. This is the last time I'll be broke. This is the last Sunday I'm going to cry. This is the last Sunday to be begging folk. This is the last Sunday to be throwing pity parties. This is the last Sunday eating at Burger King. I'm about to get back everything the devil took from me. I'm about to walk into my increase, walk into my overflow, walk into my abundance. Now, is there anybody in here who believes you about to get it back? Then tell your neighbor, I'm not going to wait till I get it to shout. I'm going to shout about it right now. I'm not going to wait till I stand, but I'm going to throw my hands up. And do you know why I'm going to shout? Because everybody in the club getting filled, tipsy on the Holy Ghost. I wish I had somebody. Everybody in the club getting tipsy, baby. We drunk on the Holy Ghost. I need somebody in here who can say, I ain't Baptist no more. I ain't Bethel no more. I ain't having church no more. I'm coming to be filled with the power of God's Holy Spirit.
Subscribe to Brother Rollins' videos for Christ on YouTube. We post brand new content every week with powerful preaching for ministers and pastors all across the nation that seek to encourage people all over the world through the word of Jesus Christ. You will also find gospel songs and old-time hymns that have inspired generations of Christians. Subscribe today and hit the bell so you never miss new content. YouTube.com/Brother Rollins. Spell it. B-R-O-T-H-A, Rollins. Brother Rollins videos for Christ on YouTube.